Hey everyone, I'm Apostle Michelle Peterson, and I am teaching from my book, The Mantle of Prosperity. This is a series of teachings. I am actually going through my book, and I am going through the requirements of the covenant that the Lord wants to enter into with His people. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, if you haven't watched the first video, just go back and check out the first video so you'll understand, and go through the steps so that you'll understand where I am in this teaching, okay? And I'm teaching straight from my book. Okay, so the fourth requirement in this covenant, the covenant of blessings with the Lord that you can enter into with Him, the fourth requirement that He actually requires of anyone who wants to enter into this covenant, the fourth one is, He said, respect and honor me. In the last video, we talked about how obeying God, obeying His word, obeying His voice, how that's a form of honor and respect. You know, it's love. It's the way you love Him. You obey Him. It's respecting and honoring Him because you're trying to do what He's telling you to do. So the Lord says here, one of the requirements of this covenant is to respect and honor Him. Okay, so I have here, we have to honor and respect God in everything we do. Okay, that may be the hard part, because even on your jobs, you have to honor and respect God on your jobs. When you're talking to people, how are you doing honest things on your job? You know, when you're doing business, are you doing honest business? Are you, you know, trying to get over on people? Are you honoring God in your business? The way you treat people, you have to honor God even the way you treat people. Even if they are doing something bad to you, you still have to honor them. The words you speak, are you honoring God in your conversations that you're having every day? The things that you're watching on TV, are you honoring God in that? What you're doing on the internet, the music you're listening to, you know, and all the things that you're doing behind closed doors too. Are you honoring God when you're behind closed doors? And this is, we normally don't think about stuff like this. We're alone, we're away from everyone, and we kind of do our little things. Or if we're on the phone conversating with someone, we let certain things come out of our mouth. But the Lord wants us to honor and respect Him in everything that we do every day. I'll read a scripture to you from Revelation 4:11. It says, Thou art holy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for Thou hast created all things, and for Thy pleasure they are and were created. All right, so another thing, the way you can honor God, honor and respect Him, is honoring and respecting your parents. You know, that's the same thing as honoring God, because God has placed them in authority over you. And so by you honoring and respecting them, you're honoring that authority that God has given them over you. And plus, you're honoring God. And so this is a way that you can honor Him also. And so the thing about it is, you know, honoring people is really, really important to God, especially all authority. Police officers, the president, everyone that's in authority over this nation, over this country, it's really important for the Lord. I mean, it's really important to Him that we honor these people that He's placed in authority. They have that role. They have that position of authority. Your pastors, the leaders in the church, they have that position of authority. Now, if they're abusing it, and then the Lord will take care of that. We don't need to. We just need to honor them still and respect them. If they're doing evil, just respect them. You know, just respect them. All right. So in Exodus, we'll just go ahead and talk about how important honor is. Exodus 20:12. It says, Honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be long upon the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. So even honoring people, those in authority, your parents, it actually blesses you. Your life, you can live a long life on this earth, but if you dishonor them, disrespect them, your days will be shortened. So that's not good. So if you've ever dishonored your parents, just repent. Go to the Lord. Ask the Lord to forgive you for it. You know, and also go to your parents and ask them to forgive you for dishonoring and disrespecting them. Okay, so as we honor them, we honor God. Okay, so the great thing about this covenant and these things that the Lord is sharing you know, his heart. This is his heart. This is what he desires from us. And when we know him, we understand him, we can walk. We can walk really, really close to him, you know, because we understand him. And, you know, and it's really a blessing. I love the fact that the Lord allowed me to write this book, because it's a blessing to actually understand his heart, understand him more, and what he expects from us. And so I hope you guys enjoyed this teaching. The next video, I will go into the fifth requirement to enter into the covenant of blessings with the Lord. So God bless.